Merci, Monsieur Jastrzębski. You may wonder what the French is doing in Italy. First of all, French people love Italy, so it's a pleasure for me to be here. And I'm here thanks to Antonio Falico. Antonio, thank you very much for inviting me. And Antonio had a good idea here, because as you can see, I'm the president of the French-Russian Chamber of Commerce. I'm also a partner at Ernst & Young, and I've been in Russia for 21 years. And Antonio has been in Russia for even longer than I have. But the idea of me being here also is to attract more Italian investment in Russia. It's kind of strange for a French to attract more Italian investment. But there are rooms, and there is rooms for everyone. And you have heard our speaker so far telling you how attractive Russia can be. And as a foreigner in Russia, I can tell you that what you have heard so far is real, it's true. Russia is very attractive, and it's what I'm going to try to explain you very briefly in the next few minutes, and kind of give you a quick overview of politically and economically what's going on. But if you look at politically, what the situation is. So Russia has been growing very quickly from 2000 up to 2013 with a crisis in 2009, but growing extremely quickly. We could see the start of a slowdown in September 2013, and business could start feeling it. But then suddenly, we had the Ukrainian crisis starting in November 2013, with a highlight in 2014, with the departure of the President Yanukovych, the Crimea story, and the beginning of sanctions. What happened here is something which is absolutely not under our control. It's under the control of politicians. And here is a problem for us, is that economic crisis, we have all been through many economic crises through our history. I have heard, you know, economic crisis in 1974 when we have the first oil crisis and so on since until today. So economic crisis, business can go through. Sanction is something which is very difficult for us to control. It's something which we do not approve as a business. First of all, we do not understand how some countries can give sanctions to other countries. Second of all, it's something which is extremely difficult for us in Russia, us doing business in Russia, and especially with one sanction, which is the financing, the sanction on finance, where you know that banks, Russian banks, cannot finance themselves in US dollars for more than 30 days, which means they are cutting the financing. They are trying to have an asphyxy of the Russian economy, which of course penalizes us. Why are we against the sanction? We are against the sanction because those type of sanctions are completely useless to start with because they are done to tell Russia, we are going to show you that we are strong and that we can penalize you. That's not going to change Russia's political situation. So that's a bad start. Second of all, they are turning back against Europe. Europe is suffering a lot from those sanctions. There are a study from the German Institute and Austrian Institute where they are saying there could be between 1 and 2 million unemployment in Europe due to the sanctions. I don't know what the real figures is, but that's not very important. What it shows is that the sanctions are turning back against us in Europe. And having putting sanctions on Russia when it's penalizing us here is absolutely a nonsense. Some country benefits from the sanction. Some country outside of Europe benefit from the sanction. But what I've heard this morning from many of our Russian speakers is true. First, Russia is a European country. We should be together. We should not be against each other. Russia is still very dynamic. And that's the second part of what I wanted to tell you, is that actually there are still a lot of opportunities in Russia. The Italian business is very active in Russia. French business is also very, very active. Just for you to realize, but it's the first market, worldwide market for Danone. It's the first worldwide market for the alliance of Renault, Nissan, and Lada. It's the first market of the pharmaceutical company Servier. Sanofi is the largest pharmaceutical in Russia. The group Auchan is the largest foreign employer in Russia, with more than 66,000 employees, and that only in 10 years. Société Générale is the second largest foreign employer in Russia, with about 28,000 people. So, and I can go on like that, talking about French companies. French companies are very, very heavily invested in Russia. Actually, when you look at the situation today, since the crisis, no French company has left Russia. And as far as I know, no Italian company also has left Russia. We have seen some English company leaving, some American company leaving. We have not seen some German company. We have not seen French company, and I don't think Italian company leaving. Actually, if you look at the first semester of 2015, according to the Russian government, France was the largest investor in Russia, foreign investor in Russia. So all that to tell you, Russia is still a very dynamic country. We do have to face the political sanction, but there are still a lot of opportunities. It's still a very large market. There are rooms absolutely for everyone. There is absolutely no doubt on the fact that Italian companies and French companies must invest in Russia. And I heard Alexander Nikolaevich Shorin saying that entrepreneurs in Russia are optimists, and that is true. It's still a very dynamic country, and people are optimistic over there. And this is why French companies continue to invest, and this is also why we'd like Italy to come and invest more in Russia. Thank you very much.